everybody. So this video is probably going to be a bit wonky because, oh my god, that's stunning. I slept in and I still had to do a bunch of stuff before I went to work. So yeah, I've left my laptop at my boyfriend's, I've left my juice at my boyfriend's, I've left like half my shit at my boyfriend's. So yeah, the uploading of this video might be a bit wonky because I'm doing it straight off my phone. But yeah, so since I slept in and still had to like go to shops and stuff, I'm not doing my usual walk. I'm just walking around the park today. See, there's actually swans there. Yep, they're all coupled up, they look very cute. So yeah, luckily the park that's right next to the school that I work in has a very, very beautiful pond. So I thought I'd bring you around to have a quick look, see all the duckies and everything, and then we'll have a little chat.
Hello. Yeah.
I know.
Stop the 60s.
So yeah, see, this is what I'm walking through. All the ducks. Beautiful little pond. I'm just gonna walk around the pond. Maybe. I don't know, I might start getting attacked.
Look at them! They're all sleeping.
It's so cute. Sorry, duckies. Just gotta apologize to the ducks. So yeah. You know, as I said, it is. Sorry, ducky. I'm sorry. I'm not trying to attack you. I promise. I'm sorry. Yeah, as I said, it's a good part of mental health. But I do like going on my walks. Even if it is just a little walk, it's better than nothing at all. So yeah. But do you know what? Today has definitely got me thinking about how difficult it is to maintain a work-life balance, because like, yes, obviously I have to work. I don't work too long. I only work about 3 hours, but I'm maybe gone about 4.5 with travel and everything. So I mean, it is a bit, it's not a lot, but then obviously I've got to factor in the travel time, and I've got at least half an hour of prepping before I come to work, and that's just like, you know, making sure I eat something, making sure I've got my drinks, making sure of all that. You can have another view of the pond. And all my cute little ducky friends here. But yeah, it's, you know, even just making sure I've got time to eat something, making sure I've got everything I need and all of that. So you're talking, for my 3 hours of work, I'm knocked out for work for about 5 to 6 hours, just making sure to eat, making sure I'm hydrated because it's very hot in there, and I do dehydrate a bit when I'm working, so you know, doing all that. But then top of that, I've got the house to clean, I've got the washing to do and try and keep that up to date and keep on top of that, and I've got an entire room to clean, and well, I say clean, it's not exactly dirty, it's just messy. So I've got an entire room to organise. I've got, right, this is the bit where I might get attacked. I've got all of that. And then I've still got to see my boyfriend, see my friends, see my godkids, see nieces, nephews. There's people I haven't seen in months. Months. I'm sorry, but we need to take a moment for this cute swan. See if I can zoom in. Not letting me zoom in. But yes, there is a beautiful fluffy grey baby swan there, and I love it. But yeah, you know, trying to balance, doing everything I need to do, seeing everybody I need to see, making sure I've got enough money to live, while still trying to cover all that. It's hard. It is hard. And I don't think, I mean, it's talked about enough, definitely is, but I don't think it's acknowledged enough of, you know, you get up and you go to work because that's what you've got to do. You've got to make money, you've got to pay the bills, you got to do this. So you get up and you obviously have your routine for getting up and making sure that you're ready for the day and making sure you've got everything. And, you know, if you've got people to look after, you're doing that. And as much as it's talked about, it's not acknowledged. Like, is it Switzerland? I think it's Switzerland or Norway or something like that. Have like the 3-4 day work week. And productivity has gone up. Like, all their stats are better. And I don't know if that's necessarily the way to a work-life balance. But I mean, I know my mum said it 100 times. You get off of work and you spend all your time off catching up with everything that you missed while you were at work, because work's hard. It's draining. It doesn't matter what you do. Work is mentally and physically draining all the time. Like, just so much. And there are some employers, don't get me wrong, that are really good out there, that, you know, they're very supportive and everything, and I love it, but trying to actually find a balance that works, that doesn't make me feel like I'm rushing about here, there and everywhere trying to get everything done at once. So the amount of times I've been like, oh, I'll just go quickly do a wash and clean the kitchen up quickly before I go see this person, and then I go see that person and I'm chilling with them. But while I'm chilling with them, my brain is sitting going 10 to the dozen, like, right, so when I'm on my way home, I need to stop and get this from the shop, and I need to do this, and I need to check this, and I need to double check this, and I need to redo this, and blah, 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 and all that. So I'm not even fully enjoying my time with my friends because I'm going at 100 miles an hour of absolutely everything that is in my brain and everything I have to do. And it's not fair on them, but it's not fair on me either, because that's some time that should be for me to, you know, sit and hang out with my friends and chill, and a bit of self-care in a way, eh? Because seeing your friends is, it's like self-care. I'm just going to jump back in my car. Okay, there we go. So I'm trying not to show you guys my mess. It is just mostly jumpers and stuff in the back. So I do apologise for that. The mess of my car, we love. Yes, and there is some monster in the back for work purposes, but I can't face the other way because children! But yeah, it's... feel like I'm losing out on self-care. Trying to get myself to a point of self-care. And of course, it's really annoying because if you hire somebody to clean, then, you know, you're seen as like to have money or be lazy or combination of the two or whatever. And I need to put my window down, it's so hot. And yeah, it's just like, you know, I have friends that love to clean. I'll happily pay them to come clean my house because I don't like cleaning. I like organising. Don't get me wrong, all about the organisation, love it. But cleaning just, it's not for me. It's really not. But I feel like regardless of what you do nowadays, somebody's going to have something to say about how you're helping yourself. So it's a lose-lose situation because
you get a cleaner, you're going to get absolutely slaughtered for somebody coming in and doing your cleaning. You know, if you're getting somebody to pick your kids up from the school run, how bad it is that you can't pick your own kids up from the school run. And then, you know, if I go and take all my laundry to a laundromat or something, you know, even the big machines, or go to a laundrette where they do it themselves or whatever, it's like, oh, you can't even clean your own clothes. And I think there's a big stigma on that, because, like, why should I be getting moaned about, talked about, name called or whatever, because I have noticed that I personally am bad at something, it is overwhelming me, it is getting on top of me, but I have the bit of extra money to be able to pay somebody, I don't know, 20, 30 quid an hour, once a week, just to come in and take the edge off. Or, you know, paying £5 to get all your laundry done at a laundrette, or, you know, even taking it in turns, like, you drop, like, three kids off to school in the morning, and one of their mums picks your kids up in the afternoon. Like, if you've noticed you're bad at it, and you're doing something about it for your own mental health, why are we also judgmental about it? Like, I even have moments where somebody's like, oh, I've got someone for this. I'm like, okay, what? Lucky you, man, because I didn't. And I would love that. And I'm not in a position for that. So, yeah. I do believe it's something we should change, because having a work-life balance is insanely important to your mental health. But also having a life-self balance is insanely important. Like, you have to have this balance between what you are doing for life to keep yourself going, you know, doing the things you have to do, and a bit of self-care. We all need self-care. We all need to take time out to do something that's just for us. Not going to see the friends, not cleaning the house, not doing the washing, nothing like that. Lie in the garden for 10 minutes. Go take a nap. Go have a 3-hour bath. Go have a 2-hour shower. Go for a 6-hour drive. Do what you have to do. And I don't think anybody thinks about that enough. Everybody's like, ooh, self-care. Yep, doing my bit of self-care and all of this. But really, your self-care also comes from your life balance, because you can't fully relax if your brain's going at 100 miles an hour, everything else you need to do. So yeah, that was my pre-work thoughts. So sorry if they're a little bit jumbled, but I just thought about it because I've just spent the entire morning rushing around to get ready before I go to work to make sure everything's sorted and all that fun stuff. So it just got me thinking that, you know, is there ever going to be a point in my life where I actually have a good, like, work-life self-balance? Because 28 now and I've not found it. But anyway, I thought you guys would enjoy that little Monday chit-chat. I will have more videos coming next week. Well, next week. This week, obviously. But yeah, this was just a very sort of last-minute video, so I hope yous don't mind. And I'll be back with funner content next week. See yous later.